Here we go. We're going to see what my self-isolation unit looks like. Obviously, it's not. It's a tent. It did say on the outer plastic packaging there that I do need a ground sheet, of course. I'm going to find that out afterwards. So I've made my own ground sheet out of bin bags and gaffer tape. Quite a good job, actually. Look at that. Much cheaper. So that's my ground sheet. Hopefully it's big enough. I didn't measure it out. Quite a good job that, actually, isn't it? I will get round to your comments in a minute. Let's see. Where's the zip? Anyways. Wind noise will now be a thing of the past. Don't blow away. Did I just talk to a bin bag? Well. Foot will stop it, or will it? Right, so it's a pop-up on its own, I think. Oh no, it's tied down. That's good. Oh, there's stuff in here. Oh, the metally things to pull it down with. What are they called again? I don't know. It's been years since I went camping. So what do you do? 30 quid this tent was off of Amazon. Woo! Oops. Oh, it's good! Is my ground sheet big enough? Just. If I put it diagonally. And it is. Oh, perfect size. Perfect. That can go in there. Oh, this is going to be so cosy! Oh, wow, it looks brilliant! Let's take you in for a closer look. Let's take you off of here. And is it still recording yet? Look at that! It's brilliant! Now, this says it's a two-person tent. Well, I'm sorry, but I think that's just me. I have no idea how to collapse all this back down yet, but let's get inside. Oh, I'm actually really excited. I'm just going to close the zip. 30 quid off of Amazon, what a bargain. Well, I've not zipped it shut yet, but... Oh, it's got a zip on both sides, that's good. Does it have a zip on both sides? It does. It does. Oh, this is brilliant. And it's even got a meshy thing as well. So if I do this in summer, I don't have all the bugs flying in. The zips are a bit stiff. But, bit of a tip for you, if you get a pencil, just a normal pencil, and you run it along the teeth of the zip, it'll actually lubricate the zip. Bit of trivia for you. And then that way, it'll go a lot more smoother, and you won't risk breaking the zip. Well, this is absolutely lovely. Oh, look, it's even got side bits as well. Look, so you kind of have a little window go, hello. Oh, this is really good. I love it. I absolutely love it. It's even got one on the back, look. Oh, this is so cozy. What's the lighting like? A little blue. Am I going to be able to lie down in here? Let's have a look. Is it tall enough for me to have a lay down? This is meant to be for two people. Is it long enough? It is long enough. I can lay down, should I wish. Look,
Oh, about not next to my shoes, maybe. Slightly muddy shoes. Put that over there. There's loads of room. Yeah, this is like, for me, this is a one-person tent because it's curved at the sides. Oh, you can get up both sides. So many exits. It's so safe. Should there be a fire? This is absolutely brilliant. I'm enjoying this far too much. I can't believe I've had it for a couple of weeks already without getting it out. Yeah, the bottom is this sort of woven plastic sort of stuff. And it does say on the packaging that you should have a ground sheet, but the bin liners are working pretty well. I mean, it's plastic, innit? So now it's going to get through. And it's got this lovely carry case thing. So that's good. Oh, yeah, let's have a look at the sticky in the ground bits. I keep forgetting that even though I'm inside, I'm still being quite loud. This is, comes in a little bag. That's what these are like. If anything's going to be cheapened out on, it's going to be these things, isn't it? There's the tie things. So, obviously, if it's blowing a gale, it's going to be caving in a bit. So, there's the, what do they call them? Guard ropes, is it? Is it guard ropes? Is it raining? I think it's raining. I love the sound of the rain on a tent. It's so cozy. Yeah, these are quite thin. I feel like I could bend these with my fingers. Oh, no, maybe not. Maybe not. The lighting is a little blue. You'll listen up, here's a story about a guy that lives in a blue tent. And all day and all night and everything he sees is just blue. Let's get on with your comments. Oh dear. This is a bit tight. This is going to be a bit weird. Maybe I should have got a smaller tripod. Oops. I hope that wasn't too loud for you. Oh, this is lovely. I mean, the background's a bit rubbish, but... it's just my feet. Hello. Say hello to my feet. There is one. There is the other. Together I have two. Oh, look. Tent window wipes. Right, I've banged on about 5 minutes of how excited I am with my 30 quid Amazon purchase of this tent. This is not product placement, by the way. I am not paid by Amazon or by... Who made the tent again? What is it? Abco Sport. Is it Abco Sport? Anyway, it's good. If you want to get one yourself, get one. Right, Sunday outside last week. Bedenstocks has put, can't remember the last time I rode a double-decker bus. Must have been when I was going to school 4 years ago. Enjoyed this episode, Charlie. Well, thank you very much, Bedenstocks. Aaron Socks has put 30... Sorry, I'm loving this tent so much. I could open the back little window a bit so you could see outside, or maybe not, it wouldn't open, would it? You can still hear the birds. Birds flying high, you know how I feel. Breeze drifting on by, you know how I feel. Aaron Socks has put 33 minutes and 51 seconds. Lol, I just blew milk out of my nose. Your face, Charlie. Oh, yeah, when you're drinking something, it comes out your nose. I did it with Coke once, as in the drink. You know what I mean? The drink. Oh, it really hurt. Little Everbed Smith has put, I am also a big fan of TK Maxx. Had so many fab bargains from there. TK Maxx is good. I like TK Maxx. Geek on Wheels has put, have you had a pot noodle recently? Nope, I've not had a pot noodle since I did the pot noodle challenge of a month of living off pot noodle. Has Mike Jeevan's done that yet? Smack Smashin's put, oh hello, Smack Smashin's has put, give me a chuckle, even if I was the last mention. Everyone's comment is absolutely necessary. Geek on Wheels has put, on the subject of success not making you happy, there's lots of successful rappers who have written songs stating that they've had achieved their goals, they're still not happy. It's funny how life works. Exactly. Exactly. It is, because life is one big pain in the backside, and then you die. Right, what was the next video? I'm sure it's raining. It'd be nice if I had a little skylight I could open from the inside. When was that? Oh, yeah, then I went to Elephant and Castle, didn't I, again? Elephant and Castle. comments, 14 comments. Right, oops, pause. We don't want to hear the sound of my own voice twice in the same video. Karaoke Mac has put, haven't left as hard in ages, Charlie. You have the power of Jesus, but you don't have the power of the Duracells. Oh, lordy, lordy, lordy. Yeah, that's because last week, when I went to Elephant and Castle, there was like the God Botherers on the street, and they just bought a loudspeaker and put a CD on, and it was really American, if I had. And it was really Southern American, you know, so it was just like, the Lord shall save you. Don't put anything dangerous in your body. Don't do drugs. Don't do this. Don't do that. That was so funny. Ooh, gust of wind. And the only wind noise I have is the rustling of the tents. Woo! Laura's put, Munda Meander, favourite video of the week. I'm glad people like Munda Meander, because it's not an easy video to do if I've got to go to work the same day. And it's also quite, well, it's not quite at all, it's 100% off the cuff, completely made up on the moment, spontaneous. Flute Boys put, the E&C shopping centre is a true toilet. The exterior used to be painted pink, because that is the colour of the elephant, apparently. Is it? In 1998 or 1999, they painted it red for Red Nose Day and left as it was. There was also a Tesco there in its 60s style logo intact, that I assume it's now gone. Yeah, there wasn't a Tesco in there. It probably was where the Co-op was, because that's in the biggest shop I can think of where it was. Or maybe where the Peacocks was. Whatever colour they paint it, it'll still look like you're in Poznan or Katowice. They're places in Russia, aren't they? Yeah, they don't need to paint that shopping centre. They need to clad it in that lovely glass gold mosaic sort of tile sort of stuff, to give it like its golden jubilee or something. I mean, it was built in the 60s. I'm sure it's up to its golden something. But the inside, I think they should decorate it as old-fashioned stores from the 1960s and 70s and turn it into a bit of a tourist attraction, but not just dynamite away the fact that people in that area need to have those kind of shops. Geek on Wheels has put... No, Geek on Wheels didn't smell, but... Smells really nice and plasticky. Just enjoying the smell right now of new plastic. I wonder how waterproof this is. I mean, I can see daylight through the stitching a little bit. But I'm hoping it's reasonably waterproof. Geek and Wills has put, was that a Sith Lord in the mask? Is that how you pronounce it? Is it Sith or Scythe? I don't know, but people wearing face masks. You can't even hear what the flipping's saying. It's like when they speak to you, like, what? Just take your mask off, you idiot. Sean Corrigan has put, the TV screen used to show some of the CCTV images, as there was no control rooms to monitor the CCTV. So if there was a security officer on duty, they could monitor the CCTV from the TV. No, because it had lines of text on it. I think it was for the train station. I think what it was, that monitor that wasn't working, the old CRT screen, you could see where it had been image bent. You know, when you see letters that have been on the screen for so long, and characters, You could see all that still on the screen, but because the shopping centre is separate from the station, I don't think there was any communication between them saying, oh, we need to replace this screen. I think they just left it. Paracosms put, I think that idea mentioned in this video of making the shopping centre a tourist attraction by making stuff such as shop signage look old, etc. would work great with Pruny Quay and all. It would. Because people are interested in that kind of stuff. And it'd be quite nice to step back in time in a way that people remember it in that strange nostalgia, or whatever you pronounce it, with rose-tinted glasses. You know, it wasn't quite how it was, but make it as the rose-tinted kind of way, and it'd be popular. Uzzy Chow put, great meander, thank you very much. I need to get a tissue, but unfortunately I have some in my pocket. Not panic bought, obviously. They are in my pocket. Shall I start panicking now? Oh, they are in my pocket. God, obviously I'm getting onto that bit later on in the video. Obviously the flaw in this video now is that you're just watching me in a tent. I think I might open the side a bit. Actually, that's some natural daylighting. I'm just going to pause the video and unzip it, because that's just going to be boring to watch me trying to unzip four zips. No, I changed my mind, because as soon as I pressed stop, it started getting a bit windy, and I thought, no, I ain't risking it, because knowing my luck, the gust of wind will just be at that side that's going to interfere with the camera. Ben Stocks has put, the Babel Bash was great. I go to a lot of metal gigs and there's always Babel people outside telling us not to let Satan overpower us. coronavirus is fine, but don't let Satan in. I'm not contagious, alright. I was just a cough because I breathed in weird. I went to see Iron Maiden in 2017 and there was at least 20 of them outside the arena. So Ghost, who are a satanic band, and there was absolutely none outside the arena. I reckon they were scared off by Satan. No, I'm not really into this religion malarkey, but how many names does Satan have? I mean, some people call it the devil, Satan. Isn't also Beelzebub and all the rest of them names for the devil? So how many names? I don't understand. I might be talking complete and utter codswallop. I don't know. Let me know in the comment section down below, just so I can go, oh. Not that I really care. I'm just interested to know why I apparently got so many names. Ian Armstrong has put, why didn't you change at Piccadilly Circus onto the Bakerloo line to Elephant? Ian Armstrong, when I do a Monday Meander, nothing makes sense. I just up and go, and I can end up anywhere at all. Honeybee has put, hi Charlie, loved following you around today and it's so endearing to hear you laugh out loud. Please don't cut out your air moments, I love them. 3! Also you may be worth saying the people for also may be worth saying that people from Eastern European countries such as China, Japan, Taiwan, etc. wear masks when they have a cold or flu or any other infection. It's often to protect those around them from getting it. I learned that about 8 years ago when I started hosting international students over here to learn or improve their English language skills. Before that, I thought there were just OCD people with phobias, catching germs, etc. But no, it's the exact opposite, manned. Yeah, I mean, it makes sense, doesn't it? So it's weird. I mean, yeah, I mean, it does make sense and it doesn't, because I know they don't want to give... It also depends on the culture of spitting as well, because, I mean, it's long forgotten now, but in this country, obviously, we had a big, massive TB outbreak, like, many decades ago, and they found out that spitting doesn't help, you know, spitting germs out everywhere, spreading germs like that is disgusting. That's all been forgotten now, and now people are drinking. I mean, people are suddenly excessively hand-washing all the time now. And, like, people have started to figure out when everyone's got contact dermatitis, they're going to then be panic-buying hand creams, E45, and all them sort of creams. Peek on Wheels has put, have all those Bible verses got nothing better to do than stand in the middle of a street spouting nonsense at people who aren't listening? Well, I couldn't listen because the battery gave out, didn't it? Because like I said in the video, you got all the power of the Lord, but not the power of Duracell. It really rests uneasy on the ear and on the tongue, pronouncing Duracell as Duracell. Big Joe's Adventures has put, honestly, your Monday Meander is better than any telly shows. Oh, thank you very much, Billy. Big Joe's Adventures. Oops, you've unsubscribed now. Big Joe's Adventures. Do you watch TV much? I prefer talk radio. I don't watch TV a lot, no. Because I found it just more and more static and more boring. Because it's almost like the TV channels have got their own agenda, and because they're so regulated now, you can't have any sense of humour because everything's got to be passed through so many different groups of people to make sure it doesn't offend anyone at all. That's why people who go to theatres love going to the theatre to watch comedians, because you can't regulate what people say in real life yet. They try, obviously, but obviously on TV they can. They can edit, overly regulate it, but just because someone might possibly could. Maybe, who was not even watching the show, may get offended about the show. Ridiculous. Comedy is in the toilet at the minute. Comedy is like the retail of the entertainment industry at the moment. Because on telly, you just can't have a sense of humour at all. Because you might offend somebody, and people of religion will then start calling you racist. Even though that is a complete contradictory, stupid thing to say. Because race is not a religion, and vice versa. And, and all the rest of it. Gender and all that sort of stuff. Which is all gone down the toilet anyway at the moment, and because everyone's been panicked by you, no matter what you are. If you're a energy-saving, planet-saving evangelist or something, it don't matter anymore because everyone's been panic buying resources and added way much more into the world by panic buying. Got to save all that, haven't I? Because that's all coming up. Sonia's put, a fantastic Monday Meander. The Retro Shopping Centre. It does look old and run down, but I love it. I think the comedy programme someone commented on last week's Sunday Outside was Jim Davidson was called Up the Elephant and Round the Castle. I remember watching it back in the 80s, but can't remember what it was about. I've not heard of it or seen it. I was never really a big fan of Jim Davidson because my parents never was. There was a big break that we watched, but we didn't really watch it for Jim Davidson. We watched it for the other bloke, because he was just so much funnier. Anyway, that's all the comments on that. I'm up and seeing all your comments. If I've missed any of them out, I'm sorry. Right, next video is Smarties Buttons review. Oh yeah, Smarties did some buttons, and it wasn't what he expected. Ooh, advert within an advert, you know. There we are, it's for the Renault Capture. I could do with a pillow in here, actually. It's killing my elbows a bit. It's that plasticky stuff, and it's making my elbows go a bit. See that? There's nothing I can do about stupid loud motorbikes in the background. Comments. 14 comments. Ben Stocks has put, Smarties used to make me go hyper when I was younger with all the E-numbers. The thing about E-numbers is, a lot of the time, it was just used to save space on the ingredients because it's just a slight different mix-up of two different ingredients. Not all of them are bad for you, but it was a thing during the 1990s and the 1980s. I remember going to primary school, and on dinner break, there's the horrible dinner lady, and I've spoken of her before, Miss Craigland. I'm presuming it was Miss, because who would ever want to marry that would be quite beyond me. But she had no idea what she was looking at. Huge double chin, half spectacle glasses, and then sometimes she'd wear the full ones and it had these extra, I think they're called bifocals, aren't they, when they've got the two lenses in with each other. And she was like looking at this bottle of Panda Pops, looking for additives. Not allowed any additives, she said. She was just staring at it. She didn't even know what an additive was. And isn't everything additives? I mean, if you had sugar to your tea, that's an additive, isn't it? It's ridiculous. My tent's getting a bit wobbly. Anyway, Jacob Stocks MB has put, I had some of these, and a few of them didn't even have any Smarties inside, but they are nice. The white chocolate ones was nice. Natalie Wires put, the white chocolate ones are my favourite, and it tastes like Milky Bar. Have you ever had the Milky Bar with Smarties in it? It's so good. No, I don't think I have. Or if I have, I can't remember. JJS Free Time Copyright Trademark has put, yeah, I have them, and they are so... And yes, I have had them, and they're no so good in my eye. Why would you put them in your eye? Is that the advert from, I don't know. Big Joe's Adventures has put, I'd imagine that they would taste like pick and mix white chocolate jazzies. Oh, them. Oh, so, do you know what? I once got a bag of them when I was a kid, and they were so nice. And then every single time I bought them afterwards, they were disgusting. I don't know why. But I know what you mean, yeah. The white chocolate buttons with the shattered bits of hundreds of thousands thrown over the top of them. I know what you mean. Fix1983 has put, they'd be great with crispy Smarties instead. Yes. They should have used the crispy Smarties, shouldn't they? That'd have been a really good idea. Yeah. Like crispy M&Ms. Oh, that'd be so good. Laura's put, love the brown ones. You see, I didn't like the brown ones that much. Python Megas Pixels put, this sounds like an overcomplication of a chocolate button to me. Also, I tried to avoid Nestle because they're ethically terrible. So I won't be trying these. When a company's that big, though, it's hard to not get anything from them because there's so many subsidiary companies that they'll probably get owned by. Windy, windy, windy. Oh, this is so cosy. I love it. Aaron Sox has put, try these new Skittle Chewies. No shot. I've already tried them, but I think I tried them off camera. I think I had a tough day at work and I thought, oh, stuff it. I'm just eating these now. And I did scoff them. And they were nice, the Skittles, the chewy ones in no shell. I do like them. I've had them a few times. Jonathan Ries has put, never ever stop doing the Nottingham joke, said Jonathan Ries. That's when I say when I have more than one type of a product, if I'm doing the range, I always say, and there's pictures at the end so you know what's in them and what's not in them. Steeler666 has put, the white ones taste like Milky Bars. It probably is the same chocolate, isn't it? James Griffiths has put, tried the normal chocolate ones, not much of a fan, but we'll try the white chocolate ones now if on offer. I think I got them for £1 from Co-op. Honey P's put, Honey B has put, Honey P. Well, I'm sure bees do have a wee, you know. don't know if you're old enough to remember the Nestle's boycott marketing of baby milk powder or something for babies in the third world countries, and Nestle then hiking up the prices, and it was too expensive to buy for the families and babies developing all sorts of health-related issues. I remember not buying anything Nestle produced for many years after that. I'm sure it happened as even my imagination doesn't stretch that far. The white ones does look good, Charlie. Thanks for the review, Mand. Yeah, something to do with baby formula with Nestle, wasn't it? I do know that I used to work with somebody who was from LA in America. And they didn't like Nestle because during the droughts in California, Nestle was still using all the water up to sell as bottled water. So there was very little tap water, and they was all told to, drought situation. Yet Nestle was still taking up all the water to sell. Yeah, I know Nestle is not an ethical company. And, they do have issues like that. I think, and what's more bizarre as well is that it's not an American company. You expect it to be more of an American thing, wouldn't you? To be that vicious. But it's not. What is it? Swedish, isn't it? Or is it Swiss? I've forgotten which one it is now. Jamie Howell's put, you should try Malteser Buttons mint flavour. I found them in B&M Bargains and Poundland. They are so nice. You should review them. That's another thing I've already eaten off camera. They are all right. I quite like them. Sonia's put, Charlie, have you eaten them all now? I have tried the orange ones. I wouldn't bother again, though. The orange ones? That's weird. Right, I'm going to sit up now because my elbows are killing me. And I'm going to see if I can sit up.
Yes, I can.
This is an excellent value for money. This is brilliant. Why did I wait so long? Right, I am feeling a bit of a breeze from somewhere now. Now that I've ever closed the flaps properly. Yeah, yeah. Like I say, the stitching. I can see daylight through some bits of the stitching. But I think the top's all one piece. I'd be quite interested to know if it started sailing down with rain right now, how wet I'd get. But this is absolutely fun. Oh, gosh. Right. That was all the comments on that video, actually. Let's go to the next video. Which was when I worked at Tesco. This series is doing really popularly. I'm really surprised because I didn't expect it to at all, which is usually always the case. Sometimes I put a real lot of effort into making my videos and coming up with ideas. And the more effort I put in, the least I get out of it, viewer-wise, which is weird. And then sometimes I can do a video in like a couple of minutes, and people are all over it. Like the latest one I did for Lidl, you know, the greedy people buying the toilet roll. But this series is bucking that trend because it's quite a long video, but people are watching it, and it's got great audience retention. Academy. So it's really, really good. I'm not shortness of breath, I was just burping. Okay. It's a bit dark, isn't it? Funny enough. I'll have to figure out some sort of lighting for my tent next week. Because it is windy, but no wind noise. Underbees put, oh, you do make me laugh when you said newspaper agents as opposed to news agents shop. Yeah, did I say that? Newspaper agents, that's weird. Smog, I hope I pronounced that right. Smog MA has put, loving this series, Charlie lad. Could listen to you rant for hours. It's a bit of a loaded word, rant, with me. Because I don't feel like I'm ranting, I think I'm just saying as it is. I'm not saying you're wrong, obviously. I'm just saying, it's just, yeah. Sometimes, because when I'm expressing, I think it's to do with the rhythm of speech and my accent. Sometimes I can sound more aggressive, especially to southerners down south. They get a bit scared and they get all defensive with me. And then because they get defensive with me, they now get defensive. And then it just escalates on both sides of defensiveness. It's really frustrating, especially after 10 years living in London. Michael George has put, I don't understand how can we live in a world with self-driving cars, admittedly in trial mode, yet 2 decades on and self-serve tills don't work. Well, in the current situation, I think they should turn them all off. Self-scan tills, all of them, turn them off. Put all the staff on one till in the supermarkets, and in places like Poundland and Boots and anywhere else with a self-scan till, where people are ridiculously bulk buying stuff, forcing everyone to use one till, you know, have a couple of guards on the door, put staff on the door as well, and just say, look, no more than 2 or 3 of each individual item. And if you don't like it, go away, come back another day, because that is it. Use the CCTV cameras, you know, They could use it because it's on private property. They can say, look, you've already been in once today. You can't buy any more. No, not today. And if the people don't like it, just tell them to go away, because they will come back. Because if they've got that kind of mentality, but they're greedy, they will be back. Python Megapixels, but here's how I would have handled that situation. Customer, is that £2.2? Employee, yes. Customer, but that bug is bigger. That book is bigger, employee. Well, he can have it for £5 then. Yeah, that was when I worked at the £2 bookshop, and it was really annoying, people coming in saying, how much is this book? Every single book is £2 each. I forgot to mention in that video as well, some of the books would be like factory seconds. There was this kid's counting book, and it went something like 1, 2, 5, 4, 6, 7, 8, 10, 11, 9. You know, like that. I can't remember the top of my head because I don't know how the book was put together, but you know what I mean. It was so funny. Icefish has put Yorkshire tea great for red water areas. Could have had a cup of tea in here. Next week I could have a flask. I'm getting really overexcited about such daft things just because I'm surrounded by a polyester piece of sheeting with zips on it. Sonia, I really like this series and finding out how many jobs you've had. I also like the end when you put your arms up and you discovered you had swercles. It wasn't just me putting my arms up and discovered I had swercles. I was just so shocked how big they'd gotten in such a short amount of time. Very annoying. Rebecca Trafford has put, my God, you hit the nail on the head about not caring. I'm not too sure about what part of the video that was in. Let's elaborate. It's quite a good headroom. Steeler666 has put, I've worked for Tesco for 12 years. Some managers are nice, some are total Nazis. It's the same anywhere. It's the same absolutely anywhere, especially in larger places and larger companies. Because management is a skill. It's not a job. It's not written on a badge. Being a manager is a skill. And some people have it and some people don't. And I've always said there's only really four types of management. You've got your first type of manager who is completely unapproachable. And only when the crap really hits the fan do they actually show their face. And by that time, obviously, it's far too late. And then they get really annoyed and then you feel really oppressed. And it's like really like hair balding, hair going grey situation because the manager's just so fearful. Then you've got your other kind, which is they're only really approachable in really severe situations. They've got better people skills, but at the same time you don't engage in like conversation with them or anything, but you know where you stand with them. You know, you get on the good side, good, and if you're on the bad side you might as well just quit your job. Then you've got the third kind, which is the more friendly. They're always approachable, you can have a nice general chit chat with them. It's great, but you'll still do your job. You know, you've got respect for them, and they'll respect you. You can do your job. They're great. If you do something wrong, they'll tell you off. But at the same time, you don't feel oppressed, and they've got really good people skills. And then you've got your fourth kind, which are really clicky. They're overly friendly with members of staff, especially if they like you and if you're friends. And if you're not, they'll just freeze you out. Quite immature kind of management. Totally untrustworthy. You can't trust them to get your pay right. If there's any problems with payroll or any kind of bullying or anything like that, they won't help. They're the worst kind of management, just as much as the first kind was. Both of them are as bad as each other, but completely different ways. What you need is somewhere in the middle. Nice content, bro, says somebody with no name at all. That's weird. I've never seen that before. Rebecca Trafford has put, I hate the general public. Right now, so do I. And it's quite, apparently it's something that 1 in 10 people are panic buying. And that's quite a number, isn't it? But then that's just the media again, just making up numbers again, just to even help even more panic buying. The media could have helped so much to prevent this kind of behaviour. And then once again, somebody with no name has put, cool video, my guy. Thanks, it's great, but you've got no picture and no name. I don't know who you are. I'd love to say your name. There's going to be a big gust of wind and it's just going to like go poof against my face, isn't it? Yeah, people are really enjoying that series. It's still got quite a few episodes to go as well. I think I've got about 4 more weeks of that, so 4 more videos, obviously. When I went to Tesco, then my next video was Panic by Brass, and I did it in kind of a spoofy, jerky sort of way, but the message in it is actually true, that brass is actually great at killing viruses and bacteria. Steeler666 has put, they'll be brassed off if they get the virus. I love the phrase brassed off. Well, Papa's Pup, was expecting you to go concerned about hidden charges circa 2011. That's a blast from the past, isn't it? That was from a Tesco videos. I'm glad you got that, actually, because that was sort of implied in the video. Are you scared about coronavirus? Are you worried viruses are just hanging around your home? Concerned, want to get rid of it? Concerned about hidden charges? It's not quite the same without the glasses and the striper shirt, is it? Michael George has put, I thought you were joking until I googled it. By the way, I'm glad Homebase is back making a profit again. I am as well. I'm delighted Homebase pulled through the CVA because it was always a profitable company. It was only that stupid Australian West Farmers company that ran it into the ground. Unfortunately, the store that I went to, that is still the store that's going to be closing because our stupid London mayor, Sir Dick Cant, has given the go-ahead for just building even more generic, poorly built, ugly flats that would be so overly expensive no one can afford them. Affordable homes for nobody. So they're going to lose all their jobs. And it was the only DIY store in the area because the B&Q had already closed down. I was speaking to a sales assistant in there and she was devastated. She was close to tears and I didn't know what to say. I mean, obviously with my retail experience, I could say things, but not a lot of them are making it any better for her. And there's nothing I could say that was going to make it better because fundamentally she'd be losing her job. I was trying to say to her, well, Homebase, you know, is back in profit now. They might open up some more stores, but just in different places, but obviously maybe not close enough to where she lives. She'd worked there for 19 years. 19 years. Rebecca Trafford put, yeah, I remember my rich relatives having breast round knobs on every door. Also recall that the heat on your hands and moisture would leave them looking iridescent. Exactly, yes, it'd have lovely iridescent sort of thing. And that's how it works. If you've got breast door handles and breast door knobs and light switches and everything, it's killing bacteria on its own. It's really good. Mum to Four Bargains has put, never heard of this before. I know, yeah. It's not really, I don't think it's got half as much coverage as it should have done. I really genuinely think people should be replacing all the chrome door handles and plastic and wooden door handles and whatever material they've got, aluminium, stainless steel. Bring back brass. You know, it might not be fashionable, but it's got a good purpose and it'll save you a fortune on cleaning materials and medicines when you get poorly. JJ's Free Time Corporate Trademark put, wow, now we know. Is that like a G.I. Joe sort of thing? We call it Action Man here in the UK. But I call it G.I. Joe from watching Family Guy. Now we know. Elizabeth M.A. Warren's put, lol, so while people are panic buying, people have decided to get new breast taps and possibly decorate their bathrooms at the same time. Exactly. It'll start a whole new industry. People will get trained to be plumbers and electricians again. Soprano Pictures has put, have you converted to Islam? Is it because of the facial fuzz? No, I have not. I've got no time in my life for any kind of religion. Sonia's put, I have never heard about this either. You're always very informative. Well, I'm full of information. Python Megapixel has put, is that one of the flat pack desks from Argos? I always have one identical to that. I don't know where it's from. I inherited it and it just was there. It could be from Argos, might be from IKEA, I don't know. I've never been to IKEA, but I know I've got them dangerous cabinets, so it was like falling over and killing kids from IKEA. You meant to screw them to the wall, but loads of people didn't. Sonia's put, hi again, Charlie. Will we be seeing the tent? Yes. Are you still going swimming? I haven't. No, I'm sorry to say. I've not been for the past 3 weeks. I know, I'm not very happy with myself for that. But I still want to go back. I still love going. I love swimming.
Also, Poundland have salted caramel Twix in multi-packs and some new Vimto jelly sweets too. We'll have to look at that. I've been to Poundland as in buying sweets and snacks to review on YouTube for a very long time now, and they seem to be getting quite good at getting new stuff in. But it depends which one you go to, because you can get good Poundlands and you can get rubbish ones, can't you? My nose is really itching. Jan Brenner's put, were there any breast monkeys in there asking for spare change? Scott MacDonald has put, boring, come up with something better. Well, I did reply to that one and put, and I said to Scott MacDonald, you are a very tough critic, very hard to please, almost as bad as myself, to myself. Something like that. Python Megapixel has put, unfortunately, I don't believe copper and brass can kill all bacteria in a room. Also, sadly, lots of brass fixtures nowadays are brass effect plastic or aluminium rather than true brass. That's true. There is a lot of fake brass going around because it's cheaper to make fake brass. But if you can find it, get it. And no, it doesn't, it's not meant to kill all the bacteria in a room or anything like that, but it does, it actually does, it kills bacteria and viruses. It's, I forgot the name of the process now, but I did mention it in the video. It's, if there's big globs of it on there, you know, if someone's actually not washed their hands after going to the toilet and they touch the door handle, it's not going to kill all them germs off. It's just the general upkeep, you know, that underlining, underlying ability to self-clean. It's that. Whereas on plastic door handles, it'll just rest there forever, if not get worse, and just multiply and breed. The next video is KA or KA Reload review. And this is, oh no, what have I pressed? Stop circling, I don't want you to circle. No, cancel. There we go. Caroline going off in the background. I quite like black cherry. I might try it. I like the scratch letters at the end, all glittery. Got them from Poundland ages ago. But the S keeps falling off, which is quite weird, because then it says crass, which is like from back in the day. Kenza Sabin, Kenza Sabin has put, please do When I Worked playlist. I will get onto that. I will get onto that. I should do, really, shouldn't I? JJS Free Time Copyright Trademark has put, Poundland bog roll in the background, lol. If you look at the bog roll, you'll see someone's TV license on it somewhere, lol. I had this in Cherry and I loved it. I did think at first I would hate it, but I did go, oh, and I got mine from Moan Bargains for 20p or something. There you are. Do you know what? I miss Moan Bargains. George T has put, I think these are in Moan Bargains. They're under 50p. I will try them if I dare venture back in. Went in today and he had all he had was cough, 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 cough. Dirty buggers. Cover your mouth. I know, there is a lot of dirty people. Part of the video I was going to use, but I didn't because I forgot, was I got onto a bus and all the windows were shut, all steamy, and I got my finger and went like that on the window and watched all the condensation roll off. And it's just disgusting. People are disgusting and stupid. You know, why get on a bus, have all the windows shut, with all that humidity and breathing in other people's germs? That's just incubating it all. Shvika? I hope that's pronounced right. That's an amazing video. You deserve more views. Thank you very much. I'm going up to 5,000 subscribers. Thank you all so much. Unabi has put, good lord, these are awful. There's no actual fruit listed in the ingredients. It's all sugar, glucose, sugar, drink with sugar and sweetener, sugar again. Yeah, Unabi, it's an energy drink, and I would have appreciated a sugar-free version, just to cut down unnecessary sugar. But then the same again with sweeteners. Sweeteners aren't great for you either, are they? Python Megapixel has put, this is the kind of thing you find in small shops like Best One, Go Local, Premier Stores, One Stop, etc. Yeah, no. One Stop is actually Tesco. It's just a way that Tesco can actually charge more for their stuff. It's a bit of a con.
Often those shops aren't the best value compared to the supermarkets, but you can find some really interesting stuff in there.
Yeah, you can.
Back in the day, obviously when P&H was still around, the supplier to those kind of shops, you used to get even better random stuff in, but they went bust. And the last video, I think, was the one I did yesterday, yeah, which is Lidl Greedy Bar Stewards. And because YouTube does not like anyone mentioning the word coronavirus in the titles of any of the videos or talking about it, I was really careful in that video not to mention anything about it. I know this has got loads of comments on it, I think. Yeah, 32 comments. So I'll get through it as quick as I can because I'll be here all day. But thank you everyone so much for commenting. Obviously it's a big part of Sunday outside. In the tent this week. Aaron Socks has put, sheep mentality, Charlie. If the government told them to smear themselves head to toe in dog poo, as it would found to prevent coronavirus, they would. Of course they would. Because people are stupid. Ugh. Back to 24 Jail. I was in Asda on Wednesday and I saw people running down the store. I went to see what it was all about. And it was a fresh toilet roll delivery. Oh my word. Really? People were running because it had been a toilet roll delivery. Oh, it hurts my eyebrows. It hurts my skin between my eyebrows and the muscles there so much. Oh, I can see it now. It's embarrassing and painful to image. People running in a supermarket for fresh toilet roll deliveries. Oh my word. I'm actually welling up with embarrassment. I'm crying. This is absolutely ridiculous. The member of staff could not even unstack the pallet. People had got in front of him and were tearing into the pallet like animals on a piece of meat. One person took six 24 packs. Greedy bastards. It's disgusting, isn't it? People. They're not people, they're the scum. Greedy, dirty scum is what they are. Because they are dirty scum. Because only now have they discovered about washing their hands. Bulk buying hand gels and this, that and the other. Michael George has put, my heart is broken for the elderly people, etc. I would have filmed that guy buying all that at the tills and challenged him. Do you know what? I'm surprised I didn't actually, because I was really holding it in that day. I did actually move his trolley out the way because, as you saw in the video, it was blocking the... Not only was the taking all the toilet rolls, but the pair of them were blocking the rest of the self-scan tills because the trolley was put long ways. So I moved it round and went, excuse me, like that. I think I would have filmed it if then they thought I was saying that they couldn't have the toilet rolls because they did have the phone in my hand. Then that would have been a better video. Little of a Bed Smith has put, totally agree with Charlie. The sheeple predictably falling for the mass hysteria over a virus. I refuse to get stressed by any of it, and nor will I be panic buying. We also need to remember that most of these selfish shelf-clearing saddos are not only making it more difficult for vulnerable people to be able to get their shopping done, they also feel the need to post pictures of their stockpiling on social media as if it's a badge of honour. Utterly pathetic. I know. I'm so glad that I know nobody, as of yet, who is a hoarder, a shelf-clearing, selfish, stockpiling, panic buyer. Because if I did know that person, I don't want to be friends with them. I think I would unfriend them. In fact, I'd go further than that. I would shame them. Because it's out of order. It has nothing to do with the symptoms of flu. Nobody even wants to eat when you get the flu. You have soup and you struggle to eat that. You have a cup of tea. You have water. Maybe an orange. Some flat Coke to keep your energy up. Just so you can barely watch the TV and then wish that you weren't watching it because it was some crap on daytime TV. But you know what I mean? It really is. 51 Foxes, but it's totally unreal. All this stupid panic buying. And there's so many people who actually profit here off of panic and fear. The shops are going to be hit by it and members of staff, because now that people have panic bought all this stuff, they're now going to struggle to not only refill the shelves, but there's going to be no customers, there's going to be fewer customers. So people are not only going to lose hours because of the virus overhype, but also because when they do go back to work, there'll be so few hours because no one will be shopping. It's this kind of behaviour that really will put a big, massive hole in retail. So random picture just put, karma for you stealing the world supply of gold biscuit bars. I know, yeah. Sonia's put, I was in my local Asda the other day. The shelves were completely empty of toilet roll. Not that we needed any. I loved it when you attempted to take someone else's toilet roll. The bike helmet suited you, Charlie. They were not limiting the amount of how many people could buy per person. That Lidl opens early if you're in there at 7:05 a.m. Yeah, it's a really popular one in Shepherd's Bush because it gets really busy. Because the only other place you can shop in Shepherd's Bush now is Waitrose. They use a Tesco, but it's more closer to Whammersmith. Sean Corrigan has put, people are overreacting way too much. They are. I've been having great conversations on Twitter with people panic buying. I've had lots of angry Italians. It's really interesting because I don't really like talking about left and right wing, but I've had people who have been saying that the hope that I get coronavirus, and I've not threatened the Italians. I have not been abusive to the Italians. I said one comment and I said the Italian government can now use coronavirus as a reason why the country goes bust because of its huge national debt. That is all I said. That is all I said. And the reaction has been filthy, dirty, nasty. And it's just like, ooh, well, you hope your parents die and you hope your grandparents die of coronavirus. Nah, 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 nah. Childish. The extreme left is just the same as the extreme right. I said nothing about any of that. I've just said that people are overreacting and over panic buying for nothing. I won't be surprised if the numbers in Italy have been inflated to suit the purposes of the Italian government. Once again, that's not offensive to people who have died of coronavirus or anything like that. But oh my word, they've really gone for me. I changed my name on Twitter a long time ago because I got rid of it, didn't I? And then I went back on it, and I'm under a pseudonym. Because I wanted to keep it separate from my YouTube channel. Because a lot of the stuff that I do would be considered as quite trolly. As in a troll. Or troll, if you're American. But it's not. It's just saying as it is. And people don't like to be told the firm, hard truth sometimes. Sean Corrigan has put... Oh, I've already said that. JJ's copyright trademark. JJ's free time copyright trademark. But I hate it as well. Poundland is having a problem. There are 6 packs. So I had to go into Sainsbog's to get a 9-pack. Well, 18. As I got to... Well, 18 as I got to, as people are greedy bastards, like you say. And that's just another reason, isn't it? It makes you look like a panic buyer because you're having to compensate because of the panic buyers. I mean, I felt really stupid buying a 9-pack. I don't need a 9-pack. I only wanted a 4-pack of toilet roll. But it's getting to the point now where even non-panic buyers look like panic buyers. And I'd be furious if the media got a picture of me walking down the street with a pack in about 5 or 6 weeks' time, you know, with a 24-pack of toilet roll, accusing me of panic buying. I'd be like, but the media have perpetuated it and made it so much worse. Is I just put, toilet paper is the new currency. I know, yeah. Because that's flogging it for all sorts, couldn't you? I mean, they brought out the new £20 note, didn't they? The Bank of England. They shouldn't have bothered. They should have just printed out sheets and toilet roll. Little of Red Smith has put, P.S. If a functioning grown-ass adult needs to be told not to wash... needs not only to be told to wash their hands, but also how to wash their hands, they deserve to get coronavirus. The Mirror newspaper has put this video on of this random doctor, and they said he's gone viral. He hasn't. It's just a video of him washing his hands. That's all it is. It's a video of some doctor telling us how to wash our hands just because he's been to the supermarket and used a self-scan screen. And do you know what? I know I don't make the best material out there, and I love all my subscribers as much as possible. But if I did a video as boring as the video he made about washing your hands, I think I'd give up tomorrow. I did do a video about washing your hands about 3 years ago. And it was, was it about that long ago? And it was about, because we have a two-tap arrangement generally in the UK, of a hot separate tap and a hot and a cold separate tap. And it's usually juggling between the two, scalding hot, freezing cold. It got about 900 views. It started to get popular again. Do people really need to be told how to wash their hands? Ellen Dorks has put, transport them all to an island as far away as possible. That's all I've got to say. I just really want to go somewhere because I feel like I'm going mad. I really feel like the world has gone insane over such a minute, small issue. Is it some kind of test? Is it a test? You know? Because are the government doing this because there's something really significant happening really somewhere else in the world that we don't know about, but all the media's latched onto coronavirus so we have nothing other? I don't know. Alan Murphy 647 has put, I try, the people are freaking out so much, buying so much toilet roll. How many toilet rolls do you need? If there was a zombie apocalypse, not many people would survive. Exactly, it's not the T-virus of a Resident Evil. You know, when you get coronavirus, you don't then start eating other people's skin. It's a flipping flu. Python Megapixels, but most of the major supermarkets in my town, none of them have any toilet roll left. The only place who can get it is Own Bargains, and they have a limit of about 10 rolls per customer. This is getting ridiculous. Yeah, you've got to go to the sub-supermarkets now, like Londis, or Budgeons, something like that. You know, the Symbols and the really other undergroundy sort of supermarkets you got to go to, like Spa as well. Big Joe's Adventures has put, no turd Saturday. Yeah, I did the hashtag no turd Saturday because no one can go to the toilet, because if you're not a panic buyer, you know, you've run out of toilet roll because of the panic buyers. Honeybee has put, do you know what, Charlie, you should have gone over and said what you said you were doing a survey and how many toilet rolls one person needs or something. Much wittier, of which I can't think of right now. Embarrass the epping S's. Exactly, I know I should have done, shouldn't I? I really think I should have gone further. I still could, because I think the self-isolation thing, for me personally, is not because of coronavirus. It's to stop me from actually getting into altercations with people in supermarkets and other shops. Because it's getting me so angry seeing people's waste and greed over all this. That's what's making me needing to self-isolate. This is why I need to just get away from the general public. Nothing to do with germs, but the virus of greed, the virus of the lack of sense of humour about the situation. That is what we need to do. Steeler666 has put, it is cheaper to buy a 24-pack than the don't go off. I'm having to actually press load more comments. I've never had to do this before. Greaves says, but I always bought 36 to 50 rolls once every 3 months. Nothing wrong with it. Better than just getting nan and constantly need to go back to buy more. Yeah, it depends where you live, because maybe Greaves, if you live somewhere like a small town or something, so it's a long way away to your supermarket. I get it. Connor Morris has put, it's ridiculous if you ask me, Charlie. It's like the world is going to end or a zombie apocalypse. The way people buy such lots of toilet paper, it is pathetic. It really is, isn't it? It's just so wrong. Gunstar Hero has put, my thing is I feel bad about going to buy my monthly toilet roll as I get 4 packs of nan for the month for me and they last longer. And people out there now are getting enormous. I hate shopping, so I only do it once a month on payday. Yeah, I know people shop differently, but you can definitely see the people who are panic buying because all they've bought is toilet roll or pasta. You know, they're actually buying only the staple panic buying things. 666 has put, my local Asda was out of toilet roll FFS. I know. Samantha Williams has put, no loo roll in Lidl or Aldi. Actually, there is none in my local Sainsbury's either. Like you, all I need is 1 pack. I'm not panic buying. just trying to carry on as normal, but washing my hands more, and that's about it. Take care, Charlie. Yeah, I mean, I've never held onto bus bars. Anyway, I've said in all my YouTube videos, whenever I'm out and about travelling, I always shoulder around thing. I don't hold onto bus bars because people are disgusting. I don't hold onto the handrail on escalators, even though the sign's telling you to. I don't, because rubber is a great absorber of germs and disease and viruses. Yeah. Oh, last comment. And George T has put, my local Aldi limited every item to a max of 4 per customer. So many empty shelves and freezers. Oh yeah, because of panic buying frozen food as well. There was a video, a picture on Facebook of somebody who'd bought all them little plastic little tubs, and made individual little meals. The fridge was full to capacity, and it's just like, so you've added all this extra plastic, unnecessary plastic, to make all these individual little meals, as if it's the end of the world. What a waste of resources and materials. Tam. A waste of everything. And they put it on Facebook as if they was proud of it. Like someone said just earlier on. It's like, no! That's not to be proud of. That's something you should be disgusted with yourself with. If you've gone out there, bulk bought all that food, and all that toilet roll, and all that bleach, whatever that you've bulk bought, you should be ashamed of yourself. And if it is true that 1 in 10 people have been overstocking and bulk buying, you should be ashamed of yourself. I shop only once a week I shop on a week-to-week basis. So this week I have a bunch of random food I don't ever buy, including stewed steak, the only cans left in Aldi. Exactly, we're all left with crap. It does remind me of that scene in The Simpsons where Marge goes into the Quickie Mart just because there's a hurricane on the way or whatever, and she goes, there's so little left. Creamed eels? Corn nog? What did beef? And then the old woman reaches through a crowd of people and she feels Lisa's head and she goes, the last pineapple! Pretty ripe too! Why can't I remember all this stuff? Oh, wow. Anyway, thank you so much everyone for watching if you watched all this. I know it's been a really long video this week. Thanks for watching. Scrass Bellamy. See you when I see ya. Bye. Hopefully, actually, before we go, I can't wait, and I'm sure you'll agree, I can't wait till this stupid overhype of coronavirus is over so we can laugh at the people who have bulk bought and who just get loaded with all this stuff. If you go around to someone's house and they've bulk bought stuff, go in pairs and get one of them to go on the outside of the house, go into the bathroom and start throwing toilet rolls out the window. Someone can catch them outside, take them to a charity, take them to a food bank if it's food, you know, go into the kitchen as a pair, you know, want to act as a team. If you know someone who is a panic buyer, go into the kitchen, get your friend to wait outside and say, right, we're going to go in and we're going to clear this effing fridge, we're going to clear this effing bathroom of food, bleach, toilet roll, we're going to clear the house and we're going to give it, and then what we're going to do is defriend this person, just unfriend them, whatever, unsubscribe to them and stop this panic buying rubbish. If you know anyone who's panic bought ridiculously, do that, because I think I would. In fact, I might just flush all the toilet roll down the loo, because in that way, when the we'll have to rebuy it all, won't we? Anyway, thanks for watching. Scrass Bellamy. See you when I see you. Bye, bye. Bye from the tents. I've got to put all this together now. There's no digging it. There's no dignity getting out of a tent, is there? It looks like I'm climbing out of a bottle bank. I'm going to have to fold this beast up again. Oh no, I didn't think this far ahead. Is it? I don't want a bracket. Oh no. It's like it's grinning at me. Look, smiley face and eyes. Why is this bloke smiling whilst he's folding his tent back up? Because I don't know why you're smiling, because I'm not smiling.